from Purdue Stadium as we are just about set to go for opening night 2024 for the Shorebirds here at home. Mitchell Spelts with you as always here on the Delmarva Shorebirds Baseball Network as well as MILB.TV and Bally Live. It's the first of this six-game series between the Shorebirds and the Salem Red Sox, along with the first of 66 here at home for Delmarva. The Shorebirds take the field, led by their starting pitcher, left-handed throw-in Riley Cooper, 22 years of age, 13th round pick last July by the Orioles out of LSU, a big part of their run to the national championship a year ago, making his first appearance on the mound as a professional. Long awaited for him, he gets the ball to open up the home season against the Salem Club, who, as well as Delmarva, looking for their first win of 2024. Delmarva lost all three games in Fredericksburg over the weekend. They were right in all of them, but a few big innings, and each and every game was the difference for them. Salem looking for a bit of a bounce back after losing all three at home to the Carolina Mudcats. And we'll see which team can get that first win here tonight and what has turned out to be an excellent night for baseball here on the Maryland Eastern Shore. Starting lineup for the Salem Red Sox, led by Liam Carroll in his second season. Juan Rivera is the pitching coach. Nelson Paulino, the hitting coach, with Ozzie Chavez as the bench coach. Miguel Blaze is the leadoff hitter for Salem. Antonio Anderson bats second with Johan Fran Garcia batting third. In the middle, Marvin Alcantara, Jostickson Garcia, and Nelly Taylor. Stanley Tucker, Albert Feliz, and Andy Lugo complete the lineup card today for Liam Carroll and the single-A affiliate of the Boston Red Sox. Defense for Delmarva tonight. Steven Acevedo is in left field with Brylan Tavera in center. Tomas Sosa is in right. Third to first around the infield, Anderson De Los Santos, Leandro Arias, Aaron Estrada, and Cole Ehrman. The backstop today for Riley Cooper is Anudis Mordaunt. Home plate umpire is Gustavo Garza. Derek Pacheco is the base umpire. And with all that being said, we are ready for baseball. Opening night 2024 here on Delmarva. So glad to have you with us. It's the Shorebirds and the Red Sox. One of these teams will come out with victory number one when it's all said and done. Number five prospect for Boston, Miguel Blaze, digs in from the right-handed batter's box against the left-handed throw-in, Riley Cooper. So glad to have you with us. First pitch from Riley is just a bit off the outside corner, and off we go. 7:08, the first pitch time here on the East Coast, and what's turned into be a great night for baseball. 1-0 pitch, a swing and a miss, a big cut by Blaze, and the count is 1-1. Fielding game conditions at opening pitch today, 68 degrees, partly overcast with a little 10-mile-an-hour breeze out towards left field. Blaze chops one to third, backing up De Los Santos, gets handcuffed, fires across the diamond high. It deflects off the sidewall. It stays in play, so only one base here for Blaze. And what's going to be an early error on the Shorebirds, an E5 against Anderson De Los Santos. That puts Miguel Blaze aboard. So not to start the Shorebirds we're looking for defensively. Tough play for Anderson, who got backed up a few steps and had to feel a tricky hop, and as a result, rushed the throw. Went over the head of Cole Ehrman, but stayed in play, though, so instead of two bases for Blaze, he only gets the one. And now here is Antonio Anderson batting for Salem. Cooper's first pitch to him. Misses just a bit inside. One ball, no strikes. Today's field and game conditions brought to you by the Maryland Army National Guard. 1-0 to Anderson playing third base tonight for Salem as that one comes right down the middle from Cooper. One ball, one strike. Anderson, the third round draft pick by Boston a season ago. Coming from Atlanta, Georgia, one of the top prospects in this last year's draft class as the pitch comes outside to Anderson. Two balls and one strike. Had a tough series against Carolina, looking to get going this week. He is 0-for-12 on the season so far, but still very young, getting his first full season experience as the pitch comes up high. Three balls and a strike as Cooper falls behind Anderson here. Got a little time with the Red Sox at the end of last season, but getting the start with the opening day roster here. Blaze a modest leadoff first. 3-1 pitch is hit in the air, hanging up there for Sosa, who comes in. He's got a beat and makes the catch. Back to first goes Blaze. And there's the first out for Riley Cooper. And a big one as he was behind Anderson there. 3-1 was in danger, putting him at first and second with nobody out. But instead, gets him to fly out to right, ate him up with an inside pitch. Another right-handed batter comes up in Johan Fran Garcia. Only one true lefty in there today for Liam Carroll. That is the sixth hitter, Nelly Taylor. As Garcia bats right-handed, he ropes one to third, past Anderson De Los Santos and down near the corner. Cut off by Acevedo, who hurls it in quickly. It's coming all the way through. De Los Santos lost it in and out of his glove. Blase is safe at third. Garcia gets the second, and the Red Sox have him at second and third with one out. One that was hit right at De Los Santos, but took a tough hop on him as it got past him into left field. Blase able to make it from first to third. Even if De Los Santos fields that perfectly, it's going to be probably safe, I would imagine, for Blase at third. Now it'll go down as just a single for Garcia, moved up to second base on the throw. And now the infield will come in for the Shorebirds as Marvin Alcantara bats for Salem, trying to strike first here in the opening inning. An error and a base hit out there in scoring position. First pitch to Alcantara, misses outside. It's 1-0. Red Sox in the traveling navy blue uniforms, red numbers, white lettering, I should say white trim with the gray pants and navy blue caps. Home whites on for the Shorebirds. 1-0 pitch, Alcantara takes an inside corner strike and the count is even at 1-1. Alcantara batting cleanup and has the shortstop today for Salem, trying to pick up his first RBI of the season. Actually, had two of them in the first series, I beg your pardon. First one, they won one, misses up and out, 2-1. Red Sox coming off a series where they were swept by Carolina. Their best chance to win was on opening night. They let a ninth-inning lead get away. And then also had a prime opportunity in the bottom of the ninth to walk off the Mudcats as the 2-1 pitch is just a bit up and out. Not by much, though. 3-1. Salem in that opening night loss loaded the bases with nobody out in the bottom of the ninth but did not score. A line-out double play and a strikeout forced it into extras where Carolina eventually won. 3-1. A swing and a foul out towards right field. This one will reach the seats and the count goes full. Cooper looking for his first strikeout or any out possible if he can keep both Red Sox base runners at bay. You got Blase at third. Johan Fran Garcia at second. No score. Alcantara facing a full count. Cooper, the lefty, kicks and throws, and he got him looking. Pins one on the outside corner as he gave him the gas, and down goes Alcantara as he watches the fastball go by. A timely strikeout for Riley Cooper, who will throw that baseball back to the dugout, collect his first strikeout ball as a pro. Another tough bat, Jostickson Garcia comes up. He is the older brother of Johan Fran Garcia, who stands at second base currently. And now after that strikeout, the infield can back up for the Shorebirds. Everybody in their normal spots. First pitch to Jostickson, misses down and in over the shoot tops as he comes in with a breaking ball. No score here in the top of the first. A leadoff error put Blase at first base. Garcia then singled down the line, moved up to second on the throw. 16 pitches for Cooper here in the first. The 1-0 pitch is a knee-high strike. Whistles in a fastball and the count is even. One ball and one strike. Shorebirds swept in Fredericksburg over the last weekend. They had a lead from the fifth inning or on in all three of those games, not able to hold any of them as the 1-1 pitch is laced foul out towards right. That'll get out of play. And it goes to 1-2. A 4-2 loss on opening night, led 2-0 early in that one. And an early 4-0 lead in the first back on Saturday. They lost 11-4 after a couple big innings in that one for the Fred Nats. And then a 10-4 loss back on Sunday. 1-2 is going to get him again. Fastball, same exact spot as Cooper rings the bell on Garcia. Back to back, backwards cage for the big fella, and he puts up a scoreless top of the first. Halford in the books, Red Sox nothing. Shorebirds coming up on the Delmarva Shorebirds Baseball Network.
We have Mr. Austin go dance for a loss and say hi to the people. Well done, sir. So here's the rules. I'm gonna count you down. We're gonna race back to that foul line. Like your hair is on fire. He is the blur, he's already stretching. All right, sure, are you ready? Young man.
Do they play like Malvaro?
Tension's building. Austin, are you ready? Sherman, are you ready? Play more. Get set. Go. All early Leo. Sherman turns on the afterburners. He's chasing them. Look out, boys. They're Austin at the line. Congratulations, Austin. You're the winner of the Gateway Pediatrics Mascot Race.
Awesome. Thank you so much.
Just send me the link.
No scores. He moved to the bottom half of inning number one. Riley Cooper strikes out a pair to keep a couple of Red Sox base runners in scoring position, and that brings on the starter now for the Red Sox. Right-handed throwing, Jedickson Paez, spending his second season with the Red Sox, was on their opening day roster a year ago, put together a nice campaign in Salem. 5-5 record, a 331 earned run average, 18 appearances, 16 of them start, struck out 73 in 84 and a third innings. Starting lineup for the Shorebirds brought to you by Preston Automotive Group. Cars cost less at Preston. Leandro Arias leads it off. Rylan Tavera bats second with Tomas Sosa in the three spot. In the middle, Anderson De Los Santos, Anudis Mordaunt, Angel Tejada, Steven Acevedo, Aaron Estrada, and Cole Ehrman complete the nine for Colin Woody's Delmarva Shorebirds. And before this begins for Leandro Arias, he'll take an automatic strike as he was not ready to hit in the batter's box. So he'll start down 0-1 here, as Paez will get a head start. First pitch coming to the switch chain. Arias is pulled down the right field side, but foul about a foot outside of first base. And that's the tough thing about taking that early strike, because now Arias already has to choke up and protect down 0-2. And he has seen just one pitch from Paez, who's already in the driver's seat. Nothing and two to the Delmarva shortstop, 19 years of age. One of the top prospects in the Orioles system. Paez kicks and deals. A swing and a ground ball to first. This one just foul again. Almost the same exact spot he hit that last one. Felice snagged that one, had a better jump, but it was foul. Get to the Red Sox defense in just a moment. And Arias on base a handful of times in that last series. Had just one hit, did draw a couple of walks with two steals against the Fred Nats, making his third consecutive start as the shortstop. Pull shift on the infield for Salem. 0-2 pitch. Arias swings and misses. A good changeup. Paez, and he strikes out Arias to start the night. So one away here for Paez and the Red Sox, and here comes Brylan Tavera. Defense for the Red Sox in left field, Stanley Tucker, with Jossickson Garcia in center. Miguel Blaise is the right field. Antonio Anderson, Marvin Alcantara, Andy Lugo, and Albert Feliz, third to first on the infield, with Johan Fran Garcia doing the catching for the Sox. Ready on ready. First pitch to Tavera is hit well on a line to center. Coming on Garcia, and he will run it down. A basket catch. Had a great jump on that one and takes one away from Tavera. Made it look relatively easy. Garcia is a good defensive center fielder, and he will catch that one with ease. So five pitches, two outs, all of them strikes so far for Jedickson Paez as he's looking for a quick one here in the bottom of the first. No score here from Purdue Stadium. First of 18 meetings between these two teams on the year. As Sosa bats left-handed. First pitch to Tomas. He grounds one sharply to short. It is knocked down clean by Alcantara, moving to his right. Fires across the diamond and takes care of Sosa. So a couple of one-pitch outs for Paez. Throws just six pitches in that opening frame. And through an inning of play here from Purdue Stadium, it's the Shorebirds nothing, Red Sox nothing on the Delmarva Shorebirds Baseball Network.
Designated hitter, number 16, Kelly Taylor Jr.
Mitchell Speltz back with you live here from Purdue Stadium in Salisbury, Maryland. Nellie Taylor will get it going for the Sox. No score as we play in the top half of inning number two. Quickly back to the slab goes left-handed throwing Riley Cooper. First pitch to Taylor is an off-speed pitch that hits the outside corner. The lone left-handed bat in the lineup for Salem, Nellie Taylor Jr.
Come on, Nellie.
Stanley Tucker, Albert Feliz due up after him, 6-7-8 in the Sox lineup. A one pitch is down and away. And the count is 1-1. Game number four for Taylor. He played in the first three games in the Carolina series over the weekend. Was 2-11 against the Mudcats. 1-1 pitch. He had a cut and he missed. Power of the fastball by him. 2. Infield slightly pulled for the Shorebirds. And Los Santos pretty close to his third base bag. The right side pulled just a bit. 1-2, a swing and a soft ground ball foul near the first base dugout for Salem.
Come on, straighten it out.
And the count stays 1-2. Nellie Taylor, a 11th round draft pick by Boston last summer out of Polk State Junior College in Florida. The pitch is laced up the middle. It'll be eaten up by Arias. It got past him on the heel, and it gets into center field. I think that ball sank a little faster than he thought it would. As it gets into center field, it'll be a base hit for Nellie Taylor Jr., and he will get aboard with nobody out for Stanley Tucker. I don't know if that was tough to come on for Arias, elected to play it back in, just ate him up on that in-between hop. It will go, though, as a hit, though, for Nellie Taylor, and the first pitch is a big swing and a miss. All right, Stanley Tucker, and it's 0-1. Another draft pick from Boston last July. He was a 19th round selection of Texas A&M. Had just 20 games for the Aggies a year ago, but had an impressive run in junior college as the 0-1 is fouled back and stays 0-2. As Cooper works ahead here, 26 pitches, 17 of them in the strike zone. Ended that first inning with back-to-back strikeouts of Alcantara and Garcia. Just ran runners at second and third. Now looking for the double play ball against Tucker. Here it comes, and it misses high. Snap throw to first by Mordomba, but back with a belly flop dive is Taylor. I'm going to get back. Had a good read on that throw by Mordomba, who got it down quickly. He was making his second start as the catcher this year. He's played now in all four games for Delmarva. A couple starts over at first base as well. That's Cole Ehrman plays first tonight. 1-2 is fouled back by Tucker. And we'll give it another try at 1-2. Cooper's starting to get into a good rhythm here. Worked primarily as a reliever at LSU, but pitching some pretty big moments for the Tigers, including in two of the three College World Series championship games against Florida. 1-2 is just a bit. Oh, called strike three. A late call by Garza. But another fastball on the outside corner, and Tucker goes down looking. Garza took an extra second to look at it, but gave him the edge, and it's the third outside corner fastball that Cooper's picked up a strikeout on. They'll make it three strikeouts now for Riley Cooper. One away now for Albert Feliz, a returnee to the Salem roster from a year ago. First pitch is just a bit wide, starts him with the fastball. Calling just a bit outside of the right-handed hitting Feliz. 10 home runs, 45 driven in a year ago. Out there without the batting gloves from the right side. The pitch home is popped up a mile high behind home. Mordon goes back near the warning track. He's got room and he's got a catch. Right in front of the fencing, they're able to grab it. And Feliz is a foul out behind home. And it's the second man retired this inning for Riley Cooper.
Come on now. Get him in.
And now the 9-hitter to the plate, Andy Lugo for the Red Sox.
Let's go, Lugo.
And Cooper looking to strand another one out there. No score here in the top half of inning number two. There goes the runner. Pitch is swung and missed. Mordon snaps it down. It's a good throw. The tag is there by Estrada. And they gun down Taylor. First caught stealing of the season for Anudis Mordon. Put a frozen rope down to Aaron Estrada to catch Nellie Taylor in the act. We're through inning and a half from Purdue Stadium. Still scoreless on the Delmarva Shorebirds Baseball Network.
It stops sounding howling like this.
It's gonna be close. It's gonna be close. Yes, he did it. You're out, my friend. All right, everybody up. Three children, two chairs. Bill, get that music.
Bottom half of the second here from Purdue Stadium. Middle of the order coming up for the Shorebirds, starting with the Summit Community Bank cleanup hitter of the game, Anderson De Los Santos. As he bats from the right side against Jedickson Paez, who had a six-pitch bottom of the first inning. First pitch to Anderson here is fouled away as he starts him with a hook as he sends it out back our direction, 0-1. And Los Santos played in two of the three games over the weekend, did not play on Sunday. He had the day off. Third start for him of the season at third base, returning to the Shorebirds roster. 0-1. De Los Santos takes one low and above the dirt. One ball and one strike. Anderson had a couple of hits in the season opener back on Friday in Fredericksburg. He also had a bases-clearing triple in the first inning. Back in Saturday's game, that helped the Shorebirds grab a 4-0 lead in that one. 1-1. De Los Santos sends it right back up the middle and into center. Another hit for De Los Santos, who's off to a good start this season. He's the first Shorebirds base runner of the home season. Puts himself on for perhaps the hottest hitter to get things going this year in Anudis Mordaunt. Mordaunt had a great series to start the year in Fredericksburg, 4-for-8, hit the lone home run for the Shorebirds that is currently still the only home run of the season, hit that on opening night. Drove in two, also drew three walks back on Sunday, was not retired in that game. Paez's first pitch to Anudis, that one's back up the middle, another base hit. Back-to-back once into center field, big turn for De Los Santos. He gets back though as the throw, gets by the cutoff man, but it's cut off from behind by Paez as it hit off the dugout railing. Did not go out of play. So back-to-back hard hit balls up the middle for De Los Santos and Mordaunt. And they are out there early for Angel Tejada.
Number 13, Tejada.
So Tejada comes up with an RBI opportunity. He's got De Los Santos at second base, Mordaunt at first. Tejada had the first RBI of the season back on Friday night. A little ground out in the infield was enough to score Anderson De Los Santos from third. Paez working from the stretch. First pitch to Tejada. Breaking ball down and away. Overthrew it, but it's backhanded by the catcher, Johan Fran Garcia. And Tejada had a nice season with Delmarva a year ago. Played a lot of positions. He started at six different spots a season ago. A lot of outfield down the stretch. Paez looks back to second. The 1-0 pitch is down and out again. Misses with another spinner. Two balls and no strikes. As normal position is second base. That's what he's come up as, but hasn't played there all that much. He played third base back on Sunday and had a couple starts in the corner outfield spots. A lot of first base a year ago for Angel. 2-0. Tejada takes a strike on the outside corner. Paez comes back with a fastball to get back in the count. Two balls and a strike. Trying to find a way to send one into the gap somewhere. De Los Santos has pretty good speed at second. Mordaunt average speed as the trail runner over at first. Both of them have pretty sizable leads. Paez working from the stretch skill. Deals the 2-1. A check swing laid off one down and away. And Tejada's up 3-1. You've seen a lot of quick at-bats for Paez here in the early going. He got the final two men in the first inning on one pitch at-bats. And now up to 13 pitches for the game and some aggressive hacks early here for the Shorebirds against Paez. 3-1 the count. Baez kicks and throws. Tejada shoots one into right. That's a base hit. De Los Santos had a late jump. He'll turn third, but stop there. Three consecutive hard hit singles by the Shorebirds to open the second, and they have loaded them up for Steven Acevedo.
Now batting the left fielder, number 14, Steven Acevedo.
Now 99 miles an hour off the bat that time for Tejada, going the other way with one. And well, to barrel it up right to Miguel Blaise in right field. And again, De Los Santos had to make sure that got through first so he doesn't score, but there is nobody out. So a golden opportunity here for the Shorebirds to strike first. First pitch to Acevedo, a spinner hits the outside corner, and Paez gets ahead with the slider. Nothing in one to Acevedo. These two guys had numerous battles against each other a season ago. Paez faced the Shorebirds a handful of times. A one pitch, a swing and a miss. Cut through a fastball that time, and it's 0-2. Best avenue out of this inning for Paez is a strikeout in a double play ball. He's got Acevedo down to an 0-2 count here. Last year, Paez pitched against the Shorebirds three times. And Acevedo was a member of the lineup in all three of those games. 0-2 pitch is down and away. He's had a tough time sticking that slider on the outside corner to the right-handed hitters. Acevedo able to get a good read on that one. That's exactly where you want to go with it, but got to keep it a little closer to the plate to get the hitter's attention. One ball and two strikes. Paez deals home. Acevedo waves and misses. Here's a good slider by Paez. Picks up his second strikeout of the game, and it's a big one here. Possibly setting up an avenue for him to get through this inning. And it brings up the top RBI guy from Sunday. Aaron Estrada drove in three for the Shorebirds with a two-run double and a fielder's choice ground out. That scored Tomas Sosa on a bang-bang play at home. Has a great shot here. Infield now backs up a few steps looking for two as the Red Sox looking to get out of this inning. Paez deals to Estrada as he pops one up a mile high. If it stays in the infield, it's an infield fly, and he'll do just that. So Estrada is out, and Paez, who had his back up against the wall as the bases were loaded with nobody out, all of a sudden has two gone here with no runs in. Now go out as a fly out to third as the catch was made by Antonio Anderson in fair ground. Had it fallen, it still would have been an out. So now it's up to Cole Ehrman to try and push a run across. De Los Santos, Mordan, and Tejada, the base runners from third to first. First pitch to Ehrman. There's a hook down the middle, and Paez gets ahead. Trying to keep these hitters on their toes. Has started to veer away from the first pitch fastball as he saw the Shorebirds jump all over him. Start this inning with De Los Santos, Mordan, and Tejada all singling against the heater. No score, bottom of the second, but a chance for Delmarva. 0-1 pitch. Ehrman takes one low from Paez. One ball and one strike. 15th pitch of the inning for the right-hander. He threw just six in the first frame. They were all strikes. Took care of Arias on four pitches. Got Tavera and Sosa on the first pitch he threw to him. One ball, one strike to Cole Ehrman, looking for his first hit of the season. Break-even pitch. Ehrman takes one right down the chute. Comes back with a fastball, and he puts himself ahead now. One ball and two strikes. Delmarva looking to break through. This would be a bit of an early backbreaker to have the bases loaded and nobody out and not get one across. All one, strike two. All runners get their leads. The kick and the throw. Ehrman swings and misses, and Paez escapes a mess in the bottom of the second. Two strikeouts in an infield fly gets him through the bottom of the second. Shorebirds leave him loaded. We head to the third, still scoreless on the Delmarva Shorebirds Baseball Network.
It's time for some giveaways. I have here a assortment of autographed Shorebirds memorabilia. I've already got a pack, team ball, bunch of players, three goals in there. I'm going to reach you here. I'm going to pick out four numbers. If you hear your number, get your tickets out. They're all red tickets, folks. I'm going to read out four numbers. If you're a winner, come on up. Ticket number one. It's a red ticket. You're going to hear that a lot. The number 1, 2, 3, 0. Again, 123-0737. Go to the wonderful Lincoln over here. How you doing? Pretty good, that's right. Here's team number two. So red team. They all begin with 1, 2, 3. 1, 4, 1, 3. Again, 1, 2, 3. 1, 4, 1, 3. Team number three we're looking for. Surprise, surprise, there's another red ticket. 9, 8, 5, 0, 2, 2, 1. Again, 9, 8, 5. I heard somebody run. 9, 5, 0, 2, 2, 1.
Mitchell Spouts back with you live here from Salisbury, Maryland. No score through two innings. Delmarva, a golden opportunity to strike first in the second. Loaded the bases with nobody out, but did not score. A couple of strikeouts and an infield pop-up. Chased the Shorebirds out of the inning with no runs on the board. So we remain deadlocked at zero. Third inning coming up for Riley Cooper. Starts out with the nine-hitter, Andy Lugo. First pitch to him is a strike on the inside corner as the second baseman for Salem starts down 0-1. 32 pitches for Cooper through the first couple of innings. Has stranded three in that stretch. 0-1 pitch. Lugo late to a fastball. And Cooper gets ahead quickly, nothing and two. Peppering in a lot of strikes. 34 pitches in total now. 23 of them in the zone with three strikeouts. The 0-2. Lugo swings and misses. Climb the ladder with a fastball. It's the fourth K for Cooper. It's his first swinging. All with the fastball. And now there is one gone for the top of the order in Miguel Blaise. Two hits and an error so far represent the three base runners for Salem. First pitch to Blaise. Is off the outside corner for ball one. Cooper trying to continue a stretch of great starting pitching by the Shorebirds, and what was a tough opening weekend for them wins and loss-wise. Did not win any games in that three-game set against Salem. 1-0 pitch is a little tall and outside. 2-0 to the leadoff man for Salem. Now they got some excellent starting pitching in that series. Jacob Cravey, Blake Money, and Luis De Leon each win four innings. 2-0 pitch is fouled back our direction just a bit to our right. 2-1 the count to Blaise. Jacob Cravey did not allow any runs across four in his professional debut. Blake Money allowed just one run. 2-1 pitch is a knee-high strike, 2-2. Money struck out a career best seven in his first pro start with the Shorebirds. And then De Leon, 5Ks on Sunday. 2-2 pitch, bounce towards short. Arias gloves, takes his time, fires to first, and retires Miguel Blaise for round number two. Nice routine play by Arias, has a good base runner motoring down that line in Blaise, but a sharp throw got him by a couple of steps. And there are two gone now for Antonio Anderson. Shorebirds and Red Sox squared at zero here in the top of the third inning. First pitch to Anderson, a swing and a miss, it's 0-1. Now the Red Sox are heavily invested in their number 19 prospect by MLB Pipeline. 0-1 pitch, a swing and a rocket to left. That's his first hit of the season. Antonio Anderson lifts one over the head of Leandro Arias. And he is aboard with two outs for Johan Fran Garcia. So Garcia bats. He picked up a base hit down the third baseline his last time up. A single that he turned into two bags, moving up on a throw to third. And he has been their best hitter in the young season, their fourth game. First pitch to Garcia. He swings and fouls one back. Straight into the backstop, 0-1. Garcia, native of Venezuela, signed by the Red Sox as an international free agent in 2022. Number 24 prospect by MLB Pipeline. Had a good season, mostly in the Complex League last year for Boston. 0-1 pitch is inside. One ball, one strike. Garcia made his debut in single A at the end of August last year. That was a game against Delmarva he first appeared in. Anderson leads off first. The 1-1 pitch, a swing and a miss. Big one-handed cut by Garcia. It's 1-2. As mentioned, he is the younger brother of the man batting fifth for Salem, Jostickson Garcia, who's in center field tonight. 1-2, a swing and a rope foul down the right field side as it gets into the concourse. Remains 1-2. Johan Fran is 2 years younger than Jostickson. A lot of good position players in terms of prospect rankings on this Red Sox team. 1-2, a swing and a liner to the left. It's right at Acevedo, but he'll lean back and play it on a hop. Had a chance maybe to dive for it, but takes the calculated risk and just plays it back. It'll be a single for Garcia, his second hit of the game already. And they're at first and second. And with two outs, here comes Alcantara. If Acevedo gets a perfect jump, he may have a shot at that one, but have to play it safe there with two outs. And Cooper, who's been throwing well, will now face the cleanup batter, Alcantara. With two gone in the inning, Red Sox looking to score first here on the top of the third. First pitch is found back our direction again. 20 feet maybe to our right, close call. A lot of fans in the ballpark tonight for opening night. If you're still in the area, you can come join by. Got some seats available. First of 66 here at Purdue Stadium this summer. A one pitch, another foul back. Alcantara put a good swing on one. And Cooper working quickly up 0-2. Delmarva does have action in their bullpen, however. Randy Baraguete has gotten loose. Cooper trying to make it through three. Next pitch will be number 50. Southpaw trying to get through three shutout in his first professional appearance. 0-2 is upstairs. Alcantara lets it go. Just above the letters with the fastball, 1-2. Cooper, the 13th pitcher to appear in a game for Delmarva. Charbert's currently with 18 of them on the roster of their 30-man. 1-2. It's in the dirt, back, and it's stopped by Mordan. Tried to go off speed there. Two balls and two strikes. Alcantara struck out looking against Cooper last time he saw him. That occurred when he had runners at second and third. Both starters in this game have pulled themselves out of some sticky situations here early. Cooper was in the first. He had runners at second and third with one out, but nobody came in for Salem. 2-2. He's going to get him looking again. Rings the bell once more on Alcantara. It's the second time he's gotten him looking on the fastball. This time he comes inside, and it is strikeout number five for Riley Cooper in his professional debut. He hurls a third scoreless inning in a row. 2.5 complete here from Purdue Stadium. It is still Delmarva nothing, Salem nothing on the Delmarva Shorebirds Baseball Network. Top of the order coming up for Delmarva here. No score in the bottom half of inning number three. Leandro Arias will get it going. Randy Baraguete continues to warm up in the bullpen for the Shorebirds. Like at the end of the day for Riley Cooper, who throws three scoreless in his pro ball debut. Arias starts it off. First pitch from Paez. Backdoor breaking ball for strike one. Arias struck out in the opening inning. He started the game with a pitch clock violation against him, putting him down 0-1 quickly. Eventually came 0-2. 0-1 offering. Arias takes one on the inside corner, called a strike. And the count quickly goes to 0-2. Looking for his second hit of the season. Slight pull shift on for the switch hitting Arias, who's done all of his at-bats from the left side. 0-2 pitch, a ground ball foul right up against the Salem dugout. Stays nothing in two to Arias. tie his last inning, walked the tightrope, loaded the bases with nobody out after three straight singles, all hit hard. But then two strikeouts and an infield pop-up to third got him through the second unscathed. 0-2 pitch. Arias bounces one towards first. It's going to get past Feliz. No one covering for now. Throw to Paez at first from the second baseman. Logo cannot be handled. Would have been a heck of a defensive play. It'll be an infield hit for Arias. And almost a tremendous 4-1 put out from Lugo to Paez covering the bag. He got tricky after Feliz, who went from the baseball at first base, didn't get it. But Lugo in shallow right was able to knock it down and almost made the play over there. If the ball is handled on that hop by Paez, that's an out. But instead, Arias reaches on the tough single in the infield, so he is over at first. Infield hit for him. And now Brylan Tavera takes the first pitch strike. It is the fourth hit for the Shorebirds, all singles. They had just five hits in the game back on Sunday, but four of those five were doubles. Ended up losing that game 10-4 after a six-run eighth inning for the Nationals. Throw over to first, and back with a dive is Arias. Leandro's got a good chance to lead the team in stolen bases this year. He's got two of them already, both coming over the weekend in Fredericksburg, but he did get caught twice. Trying to keep himself disciplined, learn to team up the pitcher a little bit more. Tavera at the plate, Arias at first, gets a good secondary, stays though, the 0-1 comes inside. To the right-handed hitting Tavera, who is the highest rated prospect on this Delmarva team. Brian is 19 years of age, number 13 in the Orioles system according to Pipeline. Still looking for his first single-aid hit though, but he's put together a lot of good at-bats here in the early season. A couple walks have been drawn by him. 1-1 pitch, a swing and a miss, good changeup that time. By Paez, puts himself ahead of Tavera, 1-2. He's seen the ball well, just trying to get that first one through. He's only struck out once to this point of the 11 ABs he's had in the young year. Two-step lead off of first for Arias. 1-2 pitch, he's going. It's swung in line to the left. It will be caught out there by Tucker. Arias has to get back. He fires it all the way to first. It's caught, and just getting that foot back in time is Arias. The throw was pretty good out in left field by Stanley Tucker. It threw Feliz a few steps off the bag, but once he caught it, had to take a couple steps to get back there, and Arias was able to get back to the bag and also keep the foot on it. Didn't overrun it. One of those tried to jump in, and another one that Tavera hits hard, just no results. Second time he's lined out, first time to center, this one to left. So Arias remains at first base. Here is Tomas Sosa. One gone the inning, no score. The pitch to Tomas is low. And a three batter for the Shorebirds, looking to connect with one. Guy that finished that last series with the Frednats pretty strong. He had a double in that final game on Sunday. His first extra base hit, also had a multi-hit effort on Saturday. Throw over to first and crawling his way back in just barely is Arias. Good throw by Paez, and Arias wasn't off that much, but by the time Paez was timing his throw over there, Arias was leaning a bit towards second, so that delayed his comeback move towards first and just able to crawl back in. Arias was picked off once against the Frednats back on Saturday. 1-0 pitch. Sosa takes one just a bit wide at the belt. 2-0 to Tomas Sosa. Another top prospect in the system. Number 22, MLB Pipeline for the Orioles. He's one of four top 30 MLB Pipeline on this team for Baltimore. 2-0 pitch. Sosa had a cut, but he missed. Tried to yank one out of here. Shorebirds with just one home run on the season so far. That was Mordom back on opening night. Sosa, who's got that kind of power, comes up empty, but still sitting ahead in the count here. 2-1. Arias looks like he wants to steal over there, but just hasn't quite been able to get a jump. And we've got a pitch clock violation against Sosa, which is going to take this to a 2-2 count. Those can be tough. Changes the complexion of this at bat quickly for Sosa. Puts Paez in a much more favorable position. Throw to first. Arias not off by much. Okay. Able to get back standing. Second disengagement for Paez. That can stretch out this lead a little bit for Arias. get two disengagements per at-bat. He can throw over again, but he has to record an out. Otherwise, it'll go down as a balk. Arias, another two-step lead off of first. Takes off the pitch to Sosa. Is popped in the air, foul behind first. That one will get out of play. Still 2-2 to Tomas Sosa. 35 pitches for Jedix and Pais. He's thrown in a lot of strikes. 26 of them have been in the zone. Neither pitcher in this game has walked a batter. Three strikeouts for Pais, five for Cooper, the Shorebird starter. 2-2, Sosa fouls one again. In on his hands, able to send it into the upper levels behind home. It stays 2-2 to the 19-year-old from the Dominican Republic. 23 games last year in the Florida Complex League. Batted 290 with four home runs, drove in 25. And Sosa not ready to hit again. He is going to be called out. It's going to be a violation on Sosa. Colin Woody, the manager for Delmarva, is walking down towards home plate to talk with Gustavo Garza. You have to be in the box, engaged, and ready to hit by 8 seconds. If you're not, the umpire can call you out. It's a bit of a discretionary thing in this regard, but Garza called it twice on Sosa, and it's going to go down as a strikeout. Goes down as a strikeout looking, I believe, in the book. Nonetheless, it is a K for Pies, and it's a tough one to swallow if you're Sosa, and that's not how you want to lose in that bat. And Colin Woody looking for an explanation. And the pitcher has, when the timer's at 15, obviously can use as much time of that as he needs to throw the baseball, but the hitter has to be in there by 8 seconds and prepared to hit. Otherwise, the umpire can call it a violation on him. Not a heated exchange by any measure with Colin Woody to Garza, just trying to get a full understanding of why he's calling it that way, but trying to find a way to get satisfied with whatever explanation he's getting. But it is another learning moment for this young team. This position player group for the Shorebirds is almost all international signings by Baltimore, averaging about an age of 19. It's a very young group, but it's a more experienced pitching staff. One of the very unique makeups of this team. Wasn't quite this way a year ago. It was a pretty young roster as a whole. First pitch to De Los Santos is a strike as he spins one to the outside corner. Pais gets up 0-1. Each team with four hits on the board. No runs for either side as we play in the bottom of the third. Full shift on for De Los Santos, who had the first hit for the Shorebirds last inning. Arias leans off first, stays put, 0-1 pitch, tied him up. Came inside with a breaking ball. Nice changeup that time by Pais, it's 0-2. And who does Mordan do next? De Los Santos had the first of three consecutive singles on Pais that loaded the bases. However, they did not score. We'll see how this game plays out, but that could be a key moment for Delmarva. Shorebirds in that opening series scored 10 runs on 17 hits. They did draw 8 walks back on Sunday in the loss to Fredericksburg. The 0-2 pitch. A swing and another rocket into the outfield. A base hit to left for De Los Santos. Able to turn the hands around on one, and he is 2-for-2 tonight. Seeing the baseball a lot better. De Los Santos had a slow start last year, but he is off to a fast one here in 2024. Certainly a confidence thing for De Los Santos, and just seeing this pitch, and it is quite the jump going from the Complex League to Single-A baseball. One of, I think, in terms of talent, maybe the largest gap you make going from level to level, and it takes some guys longer than others to get accustomed to it, and De Los Santos starting to come around. Here's Anunis Mordan. He swings in, rifles one to left. That's a base hit. Woody's going to send the runner. Arias around third. The throw to the plate's coming. It's up the line. Arias steps around the tag. Throw to third is going to go into the outfield. Here comes De Los Santos in to score. Off the second. Now third is Mordan. The throw there is in time to get him. A wacky play, but the Shorebirds do score twice. Mordan will get two RBIs on the play, or a double on the play with one RBI. And we head to the fourth with the Shorebirds on top. It's 2-0 after the base hit by Mordan. That plates a couple. We're back in a minute here on the Shorebirds Baseball Network. Shorebirds on the board first as we move to the top of the fourth inning. Pitching change has been made as Randy Baraguete enters for Delmarva, making his debut appearance of 2024. 2-0 our score. Anudis Mordaunt brings in a run with an RBI single to the left, gets another one home on a throwing error to third base. So Baraguete is in to pitch. He appeared 26 times last year, all with the Shorebirds. He was on the opening day roster. The first half of the year was tough for Baraguete, but he did end the season pretty strong, picked up a couple saves in the month of August. He will get Jacek Singarcia to start the inning. And Baraguete, a quick pitch home as he realized the pitch timer, but it missed high. They'll call a violation, but it was going to be a ball anyway. You can step off as a pitcher with nobody on, but the pitch timer does not stop. And Baraguete, by the time he realized it, it was at 1. 1-0 pitch, a swing and a miss. Gets the hard fastball by him, 1-1. Baraguete throws a mid to upper 90s fastball, also a nice slider he started to incorporate towards the end of last year. The pitch home is another fastball for a strike. Earls went in quickly, it's 1-2. Trying to work in quickly here to the number 5 batter, Jacek Singarcia. The 1-2 pitch, a swing and a miss. Ambushed him up and in with a fastball. And Garcia quickly down on 4 pitches from Baraguete. Strikeout number 6 for the Delmarva pitching staff. He's in for the starter, Riley Cooper, who was very impressive in his debut appearance as a pro. He goes 3 innings, no decision today. 4 hits, 5 strikeouts. He stranded 4 base runners out there. First pitch, a check swing strike to Nelly Taylor. And it's 0-1. And an error in the first that also was against him. However, he did not allow that to score. A 1 pitch is down and in from Baraguete, who's working very fast out there, trying to establish a quick rhythm. Taking about 5 seconds in between pitches here. The break even. A swing and a high fly out to right center. Tavera and Sosa go back. It'll stay playable. Tavera wants it. With Sosa nearby, he'll make the catch about 10 feet in front of the warning track. And that's a loud out number 2 here in the Red Sox fourth. Tavera and Sosa cover a lot of ground in that outfield. Third time Tavera has started in center field. Makes the catch. And now here's Stanley Tucker. Baraguete looking for a quick one here in the fourth in relief of Cooper. 6 pitches so far. First pitch to Stanley Tucker is up and in. Tucker struck out looking his last time up. Cooper, of the 5 strikeouts he had, 4 of them were looking. 1-0 pitch. Tucker had a cut, but he missed. Late to the heater from Baraguete, who's come in, dialed in, making his first appearance of the season. 1-1 pitch. A swing and a foul held on to by Mordaunt. Quickly 1-2. Nothing but fastballs so far for Baraguete. We'll see if he tries to spin one by him this time, working ahead in the count. Trying to make this a fast 1-2-3 inning. The Red Sox have gone down in 3 batters just once through the first 3 innings. 1-2, a swing and a foul back and out of play by Tucker. That inning was the second. There was a single in there, but Nellie Taylor was caught stealing to end that inning. Shorebirds out hitting Salem 6-4 as we play in the fourth. 1-2. A bouncer up the middle, moving over Arias. He gloves behind second, fires on the run, and he makes the play. Nicely done by Leandro Arias. He knew he had a second to set himself. Dialed up a good throw and gets Tucker by a step. First time in order, the Red Sox have gone down. We go to the bottom of the fourth. 2-0 Del Marva on the Shorebirds Baseball Network. Angel Tejada starts off the bottom of the fourth for Delmarva. Great first inning to work for Randy Baraguete as he puts down the Red Sox in order. A good play by Leandro Arias to end that last frame. Inning number four now for Red Sox starter Jedickson Paez. He's in the seventh batter for Delmarva. First pitch bounced on the ground to third. Backhanded on a hop by Anderson. A long throw across the diamond brings Feliz off the bag, but he gets the tag on Tejada, who was coming right at him. And that'll be a first pitch out for Paez here in the fourth inning. The Shorebirds coming off another three-hit inning. All their base hits so far have been singles. Mordan bringing home both Delmarva runs in the last frame. Got an RBI with one. And Aaron brought home the second. First pitch to Steven Acevedo. He takes a strike on the inner half. It's 0-1. You saw last inning Tomas Sosa got called out on a batter violation, which came at kind of a key spot for the Shorebirds, who were trying to score their first runs at that point. They got the two runs across anyway a few moments later. As the 0-1 pitch to Acevedo is hit high in the air to right, twisting deep near the bullpen for Salem. Blaze is over, but it will get out of play. And we'll do it at 0-2. Acevedo had that same situation that Sosa did against him back on Sunday, and he ended up striking out on a batter violation when there were two on base in a tie game at four. That was a game Delmarva had their chances in to win against Fredericksburg on Sunday, but just were not able to do it. 0-2 pitch. Acevedo hits one hard into right center. That's a base hit for Steven into the gap. Blaze cuts it off. Big turn by Acevedo. He'll stop and retreat. Throw to the infield. Nearly gets away. Good stop at shortstop by Alcantara. And that will be a base hit for Acevedo, number seven here against Paez, all of them singles. And now it is Aaron Estrada. Trying to build off his three RBI game on Sunday. And Delmarva had runners in scoring position back on Sunday in the seventh and eighth inning. With one or no outs, and we're not able to score them. And then the Fred Nats took advantage by scoring six times in the eighth themselves to win. First pitch to Estrada's a strike. It's 0-1. Salem coming off a sweep as well against a very good Carolina Mudcat team at home. Delmarva, Salem, and Lynchburg were all swept in their opening series. Fredericksburg, Carolina, and down east starting 3-0 in the north. Throw to first and back with a head first dive is Acevedo. Acevedo. Fredericksburg is at Lynchburg tonight. Carolina and Down East are playing against each other. Those were the two teams that matched up in the North Division playoff series last season. Now it's 0-1 to Aaron Estrada. Pia as the ready comes home. Acevedo is running, and the pitch is fouled back by Estrada. Takes it to 0-2. Acevedo will certainly be looking to run. He led the team in stolen bases a year ago with 33. Now drop back to first. Count is 0-2 to Aaron Estrada, another 19-year-old. Certainly one with a lot of potential on this Delmarva team. Almost every position player is 19 or 20 years old on this team. 0-2 pitch. A swing and a grounder up the middle. That's a base hit for Estrada. Gets into center. Big turn by Acevedo. He'll hold up. Throw goes to second as it rolls to the infield once again. Would have been close if that was fielded cleanly by Lugo. A little bit too aggressive a turn there for Acevedo, but almost another throwaway by the Red Sox. And now Cole Irman with runners at first and second. Eight hits now for Delmarva, and all the balls they've put in play that have gotten through have been hit pretty hard. Estrada picks up the base hit, Acevedo at second. Cole Irman, the nine batter, hits. The pitch is a half swing strike. Good hook by the right-hander Paez to start the at-bat. Nothing in one to Irman, who's getting his first start at third base today, or first base rather. The 0-1, Irman swings and misses, and the count goes to 0-2. Irman last year had a brief stint with Delmarva before the season ended, but was very effective in that stretch, and six starts, all as the catcher. He was 6-for-19 at the plate. He's very good defensively at Cal State Fullerton. Orioles picked him in the 16th round. 0-2 pitch is too low. A changeup from Paez, but Irman wouldn't bite. One ball and two strikes. And you're going to see Irman and Mordan do the bulk of the work as the catcher. Brian Hernandez, also a third catcher on the roster, has a start at first base. You'll see him catch from time to time. One and two the count. Runners get their leads. The pitch home is inside. Backed off Irman. And it's 2-2. And now there goes Acevedo for third. That throw is late. A sneak attack steal for Steven Acevedo as he takes third while they weren't paying attention. Had a good secondary. Watched the ball go back. And then took off for third. That's an FH first stolen base. The official stolen base partner of the Delmarva Shorebirds. First of the night. Sixth of the season for Delmarva. Now runners at the corners with one out. Count is 2-2 on Anunis Mordan. Good heads up base running by Acevedo, setting himself up. 2-2. Irman fouls one back off the wire. Stays alive. Pitch number 52 for Pius, who is whistled in. A lot of strikes. 41 in the zone on 52 pitches. Infield has remained backed up for Salem. They are going to look for the double play ball to try and get out of this inning. Delmarva has yet to hit into a double play this year. Pai has a long look in, throws to first instead, and Estrada just able to dive back under the tag of Feliz. Estrada's got some nice leads over there. I don't think he's looking to take off in this spot. He might be more likely to do it if there's two outs here, but there's only one. Trying to keep the door open for Irman, who's looking for his first hit in RBI of the year. Acevedo has a great lead off of third, not being held on. There goes Estrada, 2-2 pitch, swung and missed. Garcia fires it down to second. That one is late as Estrada stays on the bag. Acevedo shaking his head as he did not run home, didn't have a good read. But it is another stolen base as Estrada takes second. And now they are in scoring position with two outs for Leandro Arias. That stolen base brought to you by FH Fur. FH Fur is Delmarva's number one plumbing, heating, cooling, and electrical service provider. Pitching coach for Salem is on his way out. That is Juan Rivera. He's going to talk with the starter here, Angelickson Paez. Bullpen is quiet currently for Salem, rather. And Acevedo was shaking his head as he walked back to third base. He knew if he broke for home on that, he was going to score as that throw went all the way through. Estrada almost overslid the bag. It looked like he did beat it. But White Sox thought they may have gotten him early in. Estrada just able to keep that fingertip on the bag. It's not going to hurt Salem too bad, but now a base hit by Arias could play at home two more. Shorebirds ahead 2-0 here in the bottom half of the fourth. Both runners with huge leads. Paez's first pitch to Leandro, bounce to second. Lugo moves over a few steps, scoops, fires, and makes the play at first. So the Shorebirds get two more base hits. Both reach scoring position, but neither of them able to score. We're through four now here in Salisbury. It's Delmarva 2, Salem nothing on the Delmarva Shorebirds Baseball Network.
Are you keeping track? It's not there. Keep watching. You know where it is. All right, fans, which one is under? Number one. And the clock shuffle is brought to you by our friends at Crescent Automotive Group. Give them a visit and remember, cars cost less at Crescent. Now please turn your attention to the video board as we welcome tonight's groups in attendance. In number reserve team, the Delmarva Aces. And it's youth project. Happy birthday to retired Maryland State Trooper and National Guardsman John Cleveland Jr. In the executive club, the opening night bash. In the picnic deck, Delaware World Motor Association. In suite one, Ryan Christie, Interieri and Friends. In Suite 4, Salisbury Ford Hardware. In Suite 5, Shine Associates and Big Wave HVAC. Leading off.
Lead remains 2-0 for Delmarva as Randy Baraguete returns to the slab for inning number two in relief. Mitchell Speltz with you on the Shorebirds Baseball Network. Bally live at MILB.TV. First pitch, a broken bat roller up the middle. Arias picks it up, fires on the run, and makes the play on Albert Feliz. Broke the bat in half. A matter of fact, the long end of it ended up behind home plate. Fell apart on the backswing. And Baraguete had a slow roller go right by him, but ended up being very routine for Arias. So Baraguete eats him up, and now here is Andy Lugo. Back-to-back 6-3 groundouts to Arias, going back to last inning. First pitch, fireball misses outside from Baraguete. It's a one ball, no strikes. Guy who throws very hard. Nothing but fastballs so far for Randy as he deals another one here. This one's a wide strike that catches the edge. 1-1 to the right-handed hitting Andy Lugo. Played all of last year in the Florida Complex League. The break-even pitch is rocketed into left. That's a base hit. Acevedo sprints to cut it off. He does. Fires it in quickly. Lugo's heading for second. Arias cut it off, and the throw is going to be late because of that. I'm not sure if it gets through accurately if he doesn't cut that off. If it does, I think they have Lugo at second, who turns it into a hustle double. So the first extra base hit of the game for either side, and again, Arias let that, or he cut that off. I'm not sure if he lets that go. It gets to second accurately where Estrada can get a tag on, but if he does, it looked like they had Lugo there by a couple of steps, and before Baraguete throws a pitch, a disengagement is used by Mordom behind home. On 102 miles and off the bat for Lugo, and the tying runs at the plate in Miguel Blaise. First pitch to the leadoff man, laid off the first slider of the day from Baraguete as he misses down and out. Blaise is 0-2 in this game, reached on an error back in the first. Guy the Red Sox are very high on, was having a nice season. It only lasted about 30 games last year as the 1-1 pitch is swing and a miss. There's another breaking ball from Baraguete. It's 1-1. Missed most of last year with a shoulder subluxation. He's got a big swing for a smaller guy. He hits the ball pretty hard and also runs very well. A talented outfielder. 1-1 pitch is down low. It's 2-1. Now part of the reason why he's dealt with some shoulder issues in the past, he also did a couple years ago while in the FCL when he had a great season, because he swings so hard and You like to see it because that's how much power he can provide on the baseball, but also can lead to those injuries as well. 2-1 pitch is a ball belt high, missed just a bit outside. 3-1. I had just one home run a year ago, and it came against the Shorebirds in this ballpark. Salem is not really a place for home run hitters. Carolyn Clinic Field in Salem is pretty pitcher friendly with high wall from foul pole to foul pole, about 25, 30 feet. 3-1 pitch, a swing and a miss. Possibly chase ball four, another breaker from Baraguete, and the count is going full. Lance, the number five prospect by MLB Pipeline as well as Baseball America for the Red Sox, and what's a pretty good farm system for Boston. 3-2, a liner into right, that's a base hit. Sosa missed the baseball, and this is going to be some trouble. In to score is Lugo. Blaze is still running towards third. Sosa picks up the ball and fires it back in, and this is going to put him at third base. Just missed the hot baseball coming at him, and as a result, instead of a single, and I don't think a run was going to score on that if he plays that clean. Instead, Lugo comes in from second easily. And Blaze, the tying run, ends up at third base. And what's going to be an E9 on Tomas Sosa? But a single for Blaze. And considering how hard that ball was hit, I don't think Lugo was going to score if Sosa gets that back in quickly. Instead, now the infield forced to come in a 2-1 game. The pitch to Antonio Anderson misses low, who turns around to bat left-handed here after facing the left-handed Cooper to start the game. There is action going in the Delmarva bullpen. 1-0 pitch is outside. And it's 2-0 now. Red Sox have some catch going on as well in their bullpen. Harry Frias is getting loose for the Shorebirds. 2-0. Anderson lines one in the left as he knuckles one down. That'll fall, and the Red Sox have tied this game here in the fifth inning. A base hit by Blaze got Lugo home from second after the misplay by Sosa. And now Anderson picks up his first RBI of the year as he's able to airdrop one in the left. Three hard hit balls in a row against Baraguete. And now it's Johan Fran Garcia. Red Sox getting some good swings, and that last one ate up Anderson. Tip your cap to him. That was a good piece of hitting. It wasn't the hardest hit, but got the results he needed. First pitch to Garcia, misses up and in, starts him with a slider. That's 1-0. Eric Guetze is traditionally more of a fly ball pitcher because of the nature of his stuff. There was a lot of hard fastballs and sliders. 1-0 is a strike on the outside corner, spots the slider on the edge. And it's 1-1 to Garcia, who the Shorebirds are still looking to get out for the first time in this game. He is singled twice, trying to get that ground ball if possible. Break-even pitch. Garcia chased one in the dirt. Fooled him with another breaking ball. A lot of sliders here in the second inning of work for Baraguete. And he's ahead of Garcia. One ball and two strikes. A left-hander is playing catch for Salem. And be Zach Fogle. One of two lefties and the pitching staff for Salem, and there's a swing and a miss by Garcia. Baraguete got a fastball by him. It was foul tipped into Mordaunt's glove, but he held on to it. And that'll go down as a strikeout for Randy. That's his second. And now it's Marvin Alcantara. 28 pitches for Baraguete. 19 have been strikes, and the root of some of his issues in the past has been command, but that really hasn't been his problem today. The Red Sox in this inning have just struck three balls pretty well. First pitch to Alcantara, misses high. Mordaunt snaps it down, but backstanding is Anderson. Last year was up and down with the command early, but then Baraguete started to find something in August. He was heavily used in that month. Most of any month last year, he picked up a couple saves. 1-0 pitch, a swing and a miss. Starts him with a changeup to even the count 1-1. Now Contra is 0-2. He has struck out a couple of times, both against the starter, Riley Cooper. He will not factor into the decision today. 1-1, a pop-up towards first. Foul territory, Ehrman is over, but it will get into the seats. Bounces into the second level. And the count is 1-2 to Alcantara. Shorebirds and Red Sox tied at 2. Top half of inning number 5, 15 combined hits in this one. 1-2 is just a bit outside on a fastball from Baraguete, 2-2. A lot of strikes thrown in this game. Neither pitching staff has issued a walk in this game. Ball two, strike two to the Salem catcher. Baraguete deals, and he misses down and away with the hook. And this will take the count full to Alcantara. And it will give Anderson a head start over at first. Infield takes an extra step back here. Ehrman continues to hold on Antonio Anderson. Baraguete trying to finish off Alcantara. There he goes. 3-2 pitch in the dirt as it hops in off the chest protector of the catcher, Mordan. And now right on cue, that is the first walk of the game for either staff. And it is first and second with two outs here for Jostickson Garcia. And this will lead to a mound visit from the pitching coach, Andy Sadowski. So in this inning for Salem, they've got three hits, a double and two singles, with the first single by Blaze scoring the first run for Salem. It was an error by Tomas Sosa that allowed Lugo to score with ease from second. Put Blaze first to third, a two-base error on Sosa. Now the Red Sox trying to grab the lead. While we have a second, some scores from around the Carolina League. The Fred Nats have stayed hot. They went down 2-0 early to Lynchburg, but they scored 7 in the fourth and lead it 12-2. Lynchburg has 6 errors in that game. It's been a tough night for the Hillcats in their home opener. Kannapolis shutting out Augusta 3-0. Fayetteville 6, Charleston 2. That's in the seventh. Down East on the road up 3-0 on Carolina, but the Mudcats have them loaded with nobody out in that eighth inning. And Myrtle Beach with a 4-2 lead in Columbia. That is in the fourth. And now here is Jostickson Garcia. First and second, two outs. First pitch, he swung through a high fastball. And Baraguete gets up in the count. Harry Frias continues to play catch for Delmarva. Sherbridge would love to go to him in the next inning. Have Baraguete finish this one. 0-1 pitch, knuckled him on his hands towards second. Estrada's going to go to second base, and he just got him. Miscommunication as he thought Arias was covering. He wasn't, but Estrada able to make up for it and just beat the incoming base runner, Alcantara, to record the out. My goodness, that could have been a disaster, but they make the play. Two-run score, however, for Salem, and at the halfway point, we are now tied at 2 on the Shorebirds Baseball Network, Valley Live, and MILB.TV. Of the fifth, all tied at 2 now. Red Sox played a couple to even this game. New pitcher on for Salem, left-handed throwing Zach Fogle is on. 2023 draft pick by Boston, 18th round out of UConn. Making his second appearance of the season, his fifth of his career, pitched three times a year ago, twice in Salem, one in the Florida Complex League. He has yet to give up an earned run, give up one unearned last year while with the Sox. He pitched on opening night against Carolina, threw 2 2/3 scoreless, one hit, one walk, one hit, and one hit batter along with 4 strikeouts, and a no decision. First batter for him will be Brylan Tavera. First pitch, check swing, and they ask at first, he didn't go, says Derek Pacheco. The Red Sox tying the game at 2 in the last half inning as Fogle takes over. 4 innings today for the starter, Jedickson Paez, in his debut. 1-0 pitch is low to Tavera, and the count is 2-0. And almost a disaster to end that last inning. Aaron Estrada able to get the fielder's choice at second. Thought he had Arias covering, and by that time had to commit to going to second and still managed to get the out. Pitch is down the chute and a strike to Tavera, 2-1. That's one of those learning lessons. If you're Estrada, best play in that scenario is probably first base on most occasions. 2-1 is a strike on the inside corner. They called it strike three, but that's only strike two, as Gustavo Garza rung him up a little prematurely there. A little heart drop for Tavera, I'm sure. Thought he might have been out for a second, but it's only 2-2. And then to go back to that last play, finish up on it, that's probably one Arias needs to be covering at second as well. But again, it's a learning experience for both. 2-2 pitch is outside to the backstop. It's 3-2. Tavera trying to get on to start this inning for the Shorebirds. He has hit the ball hard twice today, once to center, once to left, but both were caught. Has taken the count full. The pitch from Fogel is on the inside corner for strike three. Whistles a fastball right onto the black. It's a strikeout for Zach Fogel in his first batter. And there's one away for Tomas Sosa. Final line today for the starter, Jedickson Paez. No decision for him. 4 innings, 8 hits, 2 runs, 1 was earned. Struck out 5 with no walks. First pitch to Sosa, an inside corner strike from Fogel. Nothing in one, the count. Fogel, 5'11", 190 pounds, 23 years of age from Rhode Island. 0-1, a ball down low, 1-1. Born in Providence. Has been very good in his brief big league career, I should say minor league career. 1-1 pitch. Sosa takes a strike on the outside half. And the lefty-lefty matchup, and the count is 1-2. 8 strikeouts across 7 1/3 coming in. Works quickly. 1-2 pitch to Tomas. He waves and misses at a breaking ball. Wipes one off the plate, and Sosa goes down on strikes. Back-to-back Ks for Zach Fogel. 2 gone for Anderson De Los Santos. Even at 2, Shorebirds own the hit column 8-7, but they've also committed 2 errors compared to Salem's 1. First pitch to Anderson, chopped on the ground to first. Feliz has it on 2 hops. Will take it to the bag himself, and that's a quick 1-2-3 inning on 11 pitches for Zach Fogel. That takes us to the top of the 6th inning, where we remain tied at 2 on the Shorebirds Baseball Network, MILB.TV, and Bally Live. Been made for Delmarva as we are tied at 2 in the top of the 6th inning. Right-hander Harif Frias is in for the first time this season, making his 64th professional appearance. Age 22, 6'4", making his debut appearance in 2024. Also his first time pitching in single A. Pitched all last year down the complex. Faces Nellie Taylor to start. Righty on righty. First pitch from Frias is lined on the ground towards short. Diving attempt by Arias. It's off its glove and into left. That'll be a base hit the opposite way for Nellie Taylor to start the inning. And the Red Sox instantly put the go-ahead run on here in the top of the 6th inning. And now Stanley Tucker comes up for Salem. Frias will look for another ground ball, potential double play opportunity. Tucker very fast, however, comes up as the number seven hitter. Hits now even at eight. Frias in for Baraguete. Third pitcher used tonight by the Shorebirds. Frias' first pitch. He showed a bump, pulled back, and took a ball inside on a slider from Frias. Two innings for Baraguete. Was very sharp in his first. Red Sox knocked the ball pretty hard in the last inning. Got two runs on him. There was the error in there as well. Shows bunt again. Pulled back and takes one inside for ball two. Frias last year, 21 appearances down in the Florida Complex League. An ERA of 5.5 across 31 innings. He struck out 31. Pitched three seasons in the Dominican from 2019 to 2022. 2-0 pitch. Doesn't show this time and takes a ball just a little wide. A little off the outside corner. Now Frias down 3-0 to Tucker. Red Sox attempting to put the first two on with nobody out here in the top half of the sixth inning. Frias from the stretch. Modest leadoff first for Taylor. A pitch home to Tucker. And he's right down the chute. And Frias gets back in it. 3-1. Tucker 0-2, grounded out to short last time up. Leandro Arias made a nice play on him. He's trying to slow himself down. It's a long look in. Runner goes. 3-1 pitch, a swing and a miss. More down, fires it down. It's a good throw, but the steal is there for Taylor, who had a good jump. Mordan put it down there as quickly and accurately as he could, but Taylor, just a better jump, has the steal. And now he's into scoring position. Just the fourth steal of the year for Salem. Coming on its eighth attempt. They've already been caught four times on the young year. One here tonight. Another big lead for Taylor. 3-2 pitch is out on the outside corner for strike three. Frias comes all the way back from 3-0 to strike out Tucker. And a huge first out for Hurry Frias here in the sixth inning. Dials it up on the edge with the gas, and Frias picks up his first single-A strikeout. Only Taylor at second base after the steal, so runner is in scoring position for Salem with Albert Feliz at the plate. One of their best home run hitters from last year. Has one already this year. That was back over the weekend against Carolina. There goes Taylor again. Pitches low. Mordan will elect not to throw it, and they're going to stop play. And I think they're going to send him. Nope, they're going to call out. They're going to call out Feliz for interference. They're going to send back Taylor, and this is a potential gift for Delmarva. Liam Carroll is on the way out. Feliz, at least from my vantage point, clearly obstructed with the throw from Mordan, but at the same time, it didn't look like he was going to get him, but that is not part of the equation here. Taylor, who had third stolen easily, has to go back, and obviously the tough part about this is Feliz is out automatically. Now, Liam Carroll is out to get an explanation from the home plate umpire, Gustavo Garza, but this obviously would be a huge out for the Shorebirds here, and that was the call. Garza behind home plate. Liam Carroll trying to get a full explanation on this, and not sure he's making any progress, but trying to get a clarification of the rule here. And he might be arguing that he had that base stolen and Mordan did not make a throw. And he's letting him hear about it as he goes back to the dugout. He's letting him say his piece, and no ejection as Liam Carroll goes back to the dugout. But again, the situation that just occurred. Feliz is out on the violation. He obstructed on the throw for Mordan. Taylor has to go back to second base, so no steal for him. And again, that is a huge out for Frias because now there are two gone in the inning. Taylor still at second, and now here is Andy Lugo, the nine hitter. First pitch is in the dirt and through the five hole of Mordan. Up to third goes Taylor, so he'll get third. But obviously, when you consider the events of what just happened, that could have been a run potentially if that same pitch would have occurred. And Taylor ends up at third. It'll be a wild pitch on Frias. Count is 1-0 to Lugo, who has the only extra base hit in this game. He doubled last inning, was one of two guys to score for Salem. 1-0, a bender for a strike. As he takes one to the outside corner. Good breaking ball by Frias. Evens the count at 1-1. Right-hander Hurry Frias signed by the Orioles in April of 2019 as an international free agent. Break-even pitch. A bouncer up the middle. Long way to go for Estrada. It's off his glove and trickles into left center. This will give Salem the lead. It's the second knock of the game for Andy Lugo. And for the first time tonight, the Red Sox are in front 3-2. Estrada, he was able to get a glove on it, but not fully squeeze it. Even if he does, I don't think he's going to have a play on Lugo, who's very fast. So Lugo picks up the RBI. Taylor scores from third. Three unanswered runs for the Red Sox, puts him up by a penny. And now Miguel Blais takes a first pitch strike on a breaking ball from Frias. Blais had a hard hit single to right just an inning ago, and one that scooted by Tomas Sosa that allowed him to get all the way to third base. Throw to first is going to be late. And Frias lost his balance a bit off the mound. Right now, the story in the young season for Delmarva is they have been able to get leads in every game they've played in so far, but they just have not been able to hold them. It's been about this point in the game where they just have not been able to squeeze it. The 1-0 pitch is low. Throw down by Mordan is going to be late. And safe is the call. A stolen base for Andy Lugo. The count is 1-1 after that pitch there, I believe, as Blais takes one inside. Another steal and an insurance run now in scoring position for Lugo. Frias looks towards second, comes home with it. It's lined to right, hooking near the pole, but foul as it gets out of play. And back to second base goes Lugo, who is jumping on contact. Frias trying to keep the damage to just one run here in the inning. The count is 1-2 to Miguel Blais. Lugo, the runner at second. Estrada holds him out from behind. He lifts the leg and deals. A jam shot fly ball into shallow center. Estrada, the second baseman, is back. He'll call it and catch it, and that will retire the side. But Salem grabs the lead on a two-out single by Andy Lugo to plate Nellie Taylor. We're through 5.5 now from Purdue Stadium. It's now Salem 3, Delmarva 2 on the Delmarva Shorebirds Baseball Network, Valley Live and MILB.TV. Five, six, and seven coming up for Delmarva, who now trails in this game 3-2. Andy Lugo giving the Red Sox the lead with a two-out RBI single to bring home Nellie Taylor. Second inning of work coming up for Zach Fogle. And gets a Nunes Mordan to start. Angel Tejada, Steven Acevedo follow. First pitch, swing and a miss by Mordan, who's late to one. Nothing and one the count. Fogle works quickly. The 0-1 is right down the middle, and quickly nothing in two. Now Marva scored both of their runs in the third. Both came in off the bat of Mordan, who singled home Leandro Arias. De Los Santos followed him home on a throwing error. Mordan was thrown out at third on the play, trying to make it all the way there from first. 0-2 is too low. Goes off speed that time, and it's 1-2. Has two more hits today. He is 6-for-10 in the young season with three walks. 1-2 pitch. Mordan takes one high, 2-2. Also three RBIs, including the lone Delmarva homer. Cleared the left field wall on opening night in Fredericksburg. 2-2 pitch. Mordan swings and just gets a piece. Got a piece of the catcher as well. And Johan Fran Garcia got a piece of his wrist. Winner of this game will get their first victory of the season. Both these clubs coming off sweeps back in the opening weekend. 2-2. Mordan sends one in the air on a line to center. Garcia got back quickly and makes the catch. I think Mordan broke his bat on that one as well. Ends up being a long lineup for Mordan to start out the home sixth. First time they've retired him in this game, and now Angel Tejada with the bases empty. Tejada comes up from the right side, infield ready straight up for the Red Sox. Fogle has retired every four hitters he's faced so far. Tejada drops a bunt right back to the mound. Fogle picks it up and quickly makes the play at first. Sneak attack there by Tejada, but put a little too much English on it as it went right back to Fogle. And there are quickly two gone for the Shorebirds, and the base is still empty for Steven Acevedo. Not a bad idea, but a little too hard off the bat there. And Fogle fielding his position well. Nice calm throw to get Tejada. So two gone now for Acevedo. First pitch is a bouncer towards short on two hops. It's played by Alcantara. Low throw, but it's picked by Feliz, and he got him by a half a step. Nice hands by the Salem first baseman as Marvin Alcantara gets one quickly there on a hop. And the Shorebirds are quickly erased in the sixth. Two scoreless innings for Fogle in 18 pitches. Seventh inning coming up. It's Salem 3, Delmarva 2 on the Shorebirds Baseball Network. Of the seventh, Mitchell Spellens back with you here from Purdue Stadium. Opening night here in Delmarva. Shorebirds facing a one-run deficit. As Harif Frias is out for his second inning. Game Delmarva led 2-0 after three. Red Sox have scored the last three. Antonio Anderson starts it off. First pitch from Frias misses down and in. And the count goes to 1-0. Anderson, two hits tonight, was hitless in the opening series against Carolina, but looking a lot more relaxed at the plate. 1-0 pitch from Frias, a ground ball foul right up against the Salem dugout. One ball and one strike. A talented kid, Anderson. Red Sox signed him away from a commitment to Georgia Tech. Great prep prospect coming from the Atlanta area. 1-1 pitch, a swing and a miss. Pounds a fastball down and in, and Anderson is down a ball and two strikes. Out of the order up here for Salem, trying to extend their lead. Free is trying to keep it where it is. 1-2 offering. A swing and a looper into right center. Back goes Estrada, and he'll get there in time to make the catch. Had a great jump on that one. Hung in the air just long enough for him to get comfortable under it. That'll pop out in shallow right, caught by the Delmarva second baseman. And the bases will be empty here for Johan Fran Garcia, who is 2-for-3 tonight. There are singles in his first two at-bats, struck out his last time at the plate. That was against Randy Baraguete. Frias' first pitch is down and out. 1-0 to Garcia. At 274, six home runs, 37 driven in across 42 games a year ago. 1-0 pitch is down and away, 2-0. Did the bulk of his work in the FCL. And just a little over 200 in his brief time in Salem last year, but starting to feel a lot more comfortable here in his first full year. 2-0 pitch, a swing and a miss, 2-1. And sometimes just getting a feel for the level and also an additional camp under your belt can certainly make you feel a lot better about your position here in single A. 2-1 pitch, breaking ball, muscled back into the wire, 2-2 to Johan Fran Garcia. As Frias trying to finish him off, had a couple hits against him in the last inning that resulted in the one run that is currently the difference. Salem has the last five hits in this game. Delmarva at one point owned the hit column 8-4. Sherbert don't have a hit since the fourth. Here's the 2-2 offering. Garcia pops one in the air, foul towards first. Eaten up on an inside pitch from Frias, but able to stay alive. First of six here this week. It's the first series of the year between Delmarva and Salem. The Shorebirds won this series last year, 13 games to 11. Two-two pitch. It's inside, almost hit him, and that will take the count full. Delmarva won the season series against two opponents last year. Salem was one of them. The other one was Lynchburg, who they'll see next month for the first time on the road. Long look in by Frias, deals the 3-2. It is up and in, almost hit him. Instead, it's ball four. Adam 1-2, but not able to finish him off. And a one-out base runner for Salem, and what is the first walk for Harry Frias. And now a base runner is out there for Marvin Alcantara. Delmarva and Salem will play all throughout this week until Sunday, but then they will not see each other again until August. They'll play two series in that month. First pitch to Alcantara, misses wide from Frias. And out to the mound goes Mordaunt to talk with him. Try and settle his nerves. 21 pitches for Frias, 11 strikes so far. This is the first of 18 matchups between the two clubs. Two series will be played here in Delmarva. The one lone one will be at the beginning of August in Salem. It'll be a long time without seeing one opponent within your own division. I'm sure these two teams will look a lot different come that time. Ready on righty. First pitch to Alcantara. Misses down low after the second pitch. It misses, and it's 2-0. Marva heads off to Down East next week. 2-0 pitch is down low and away again. Frias down 3-0 now. They get some action going in the bullpen. Grabiel Salazar is getting loose for the Shorebirds. He had one appearance last week against the Fred Nats. 3-0 the count to Alcantara. Frias trying to avoid back-to-back walks. Here he comes, and it's going to catch the outside corner. 3-1 the count. Salem up 3-2 in what's turned into a low-scoring affair. A lot of hits, but only five combined runs. 3-1 pitch is down low and away. He lost him. Five-pitch walk to Alcantara. Now Frias and the Shorebirds in a little bit of trouble here. In the seventh inning as Garcia takes second. Alcantara to first. It's his second walk. Three walks in this game. Alcantara's drawn two of them. And now it's Shostak Singh Garcia. Big swinger up there for the Red Sox. They're trying to add on to their one-run lead. Freese's first pitch is down low and away. Starts him with a hook. Garcia, another fast base runner for Salem. He's a tough guy to double off. Younger brother at second base. Now Contour at first. 1-0 pitch is inside. It gets away from Mordon, and both runners move up. That might be a pass ball. Looks certainly catchable for Mordon, and it will in fact be that. So that could very much come back to hurt the Shorebirds here. Takes that double play out of commission. On a ball that might have just been a misread by Mordon, a cross-up potentially, and now Andy Sadowski, the pitching coach, is going to come talk with Frias as he struggles to find his command here in the second inning. Garcia moves to third, Alcantara at second as the first year. Pitching coach for Delmarva is Alex Sadowski, was in the Florida Complex League last year and worked with Frias all throughout the summer there. As the two will have a conversation. Some scores from around Birdland. We've got the single-A matchup between Baltimore and Boston here in Salisbury. We had the Major League matchup at Fenway Park today. Corbin Burns pitched very well over seven innings, helped the Orioles win that one 7-1. Aberdeen in their home opener up 3-0 over a very talented Wilmington Blue Rocks team. That's the high A club for Washington. Moises Chasse started that game for the Ironbirds. Norfolk trailing at home 5-1 to Scranton Wilkes-Barre, and Bowie and Hartford are tied at 3. Bay Sox are playing on the road. That is in the bottom of the sixth inning. 3-2 our score here. 2-0 the count to Garcia with the infield now in for the Shorebirds. The pitch home is outside. It's 3-0. Salazar's been getting loose for a while. If Frias loses Garcia here, you wonder if they make the call to the bullpen. 28 pitches for Frias. Only 12 have been strikes. Down 3-0 here to Garcia. He lifts the leg and throws. He swings half-heartedly and fouls it back off the netting. And it's 3-1. Downfield relatively shallow for Delmarva as well, especially Acevedo in left and Sosa in right. Tavera is the deepest in center. 3-1. It's outside. Three consecutive walks here for Harif Frias, and the bases are full of Red Sox with one out. And essentially a make-or-break moment for the Shorebirds in this game. And it'll be Nellie Taylor. And here comes the manager, Colin Woody, to make a pitch and change. So Frias, who had moments of brilliance in the last inning for the Shorebirds, he is going to come out here with the bases loaded. He has walked three consecutive Red Sox, and now it'll be up to Grabiel Salazar to try and keep him there. 3-2 Salem, top of the seventh inning. Right-hander coming on for the Shorebirds as the Red Sox have him loaded. We're back in 60 seconds on the Shorebirds Baseball Network, MILB.TV, and Valley Live. Gabriel Salazar is in for Delmarva. He's going to inherit a tough spot here. Bases full of Red Sox in the top of the seventh inning with one man out. First man this inning was Antonio Anderson, who had a shallow pop fly to right. And the last three hitters have all walked against Harif Frias. He is out of the game. Salazar is in. He faced one batter back on opening night. He struck him out. So second appearance of the year. He's the first Shorebird to appear twice in a game. And his first batter will be Nellie Taylor. Red Sox have him loaded up by one. Base hit likely scores a couple. And Alcantara having good speed at second. Salazar against Taylor. First pitch is down and in. One ball, no strikes.
Come on, man.
One of the key themes for Delmarva in the previous series in Fredericksburg is they were bitten by the beginning. That's really what set them back, and this potentially has the makings of another one if Salazar can't work his way out of it. 1-0 pitch is too low, 2-0. It was a 3-run six that helped the Fred Nats win back on opening night. They had a 5 and a 4-run inning back on Saturday and then a 6-run eighth back on Sunday. Helped them win all three games. 2-0. There's a strike. Good hook on the inside corner by Salazar. Two balls and a strike. A former outfielder turned to a pitcher. This is his third full season working on the mound. 2-1. A ball in the dirt, knocked down by Mordaunt. Keeps it in front, but the count is now 3-1, and a walk scores a run for Salem. All the base runners out there for the Red Sox have reached via the free pass. Now, Marva, prior to this inning, had just one walk. They've got three in this inning alone, all coming from Frias. Here's the 3-1. It is down low and in. He walked him, and a run's going to score. Ellie Taylor picks up an RBI the easiest way possible. Four consecutive base on balls for Salem, and they have a 4-2 lead. And the bases will remain loaded, most importantly. That run will go against Frias, but the last thing you want to do if you're Delmarva is walk in runs, especially in a game that is now within striking distance and possibly going further. Stanley Tucker now fouls one back out of play. He'll start 0-1. On the left fielder for Salem, who is 0-3. Infield is backed up for Delmarva. They're going to go for the double play if they can get it. 0-1. Hey, so another foul. Quickly 0-2 on Tucker. Tucker still looking for his first hit. He is 0-8 on the young season. And a couple of starts in the opening series against Carolina last weekend. 0-2. Breaking ball, swung and missed. Salazar left it up there, but Tucker couldn't turn it around. And that's a key strikeout, second out of the inning. Third strikeout for Tucker today. Now potentially a game-changing at-bat here for the Shorebirds. Feliz controversially was called out in the last inning on a violation as he did not allow Mordaunt to throw down to third, did not get out of his way. First pitch to Feliz, he had a big cut, but he missed 0-1. Only saw two pitches in the sequence before home plate umpire Gustavo Garza called him out. Fell out of the batter's box and obstructed the throwing lane of Mordaunt. 0-1. Breaking ball is up and in. Pops off the glove of Mordaunt, but he keeps it nearby. And it's 1-1. Shorebirds will have Estrada, Ehrman, and Arias due up in the seventh. Zach Fogle, who has been pitching for Salem, has been in the dugout for a long time, but he has yet to give up anything to the Shorebirds in two innings. 1-1 pitch. There's a bender missing low. And it's two balls and a strike. Now walk scores a run. Salazar has gone back to the windup with the bases loaded. Nowhere for the runners to go. 2-1. And here's a strike. Bullseye on the outside corner. Comes back with the gas. 2-2. Feliz does strike out quite a bit, but he also has the power to put this game out of reach. 2-2 pitch. Half swing. It gets under the glove of Mordaunt. Everyone's going to move up a base, and another run is going to score. And between all that, they can't ask for an appeal either. It's going to be a wild pitch for Salazar. And if he keeps that nearby and you appeal, you might get a swing on that. It was pretty close. But instead, Mordaunt couldn't find the ball, and as a result, the appeal becomes moot at that point. And another run is in, and it's now 5-2. Now Contreras scores, Garcia to third, Taylor to second. Count goes full here. The pitch is off the outside corner. He walked him. And that will keep the bases loaded as first base was briefly unoccupied. Now five walks in the inning for Delmarva. And it'll be Andy Lugo who drove in the go-ahead run last inning. Five walks in the inning, two runs of score without the benefit of a hit for the Red Sox. First pitch from Salazar, he swung and missed. Came inside with a fastball 0-1. 15th pitch for Salazar. Red Sox trying to break it open. Shorebird's trying to stay within arm's length. 0-1 is up and out. Another heater from Graviel. One ball and one strike. And Fogle has been in the dugout for Salem for a long time, but he's been throwing well. Now has a three-run lead to work with. 1-1 pitch. That's right down the chute. 1-2 to the nine hitter. Lugo is the eighth man to hit this inning for Salem. Five walks, a strikeout, and a pop fly to right center. 1-2, a swing and a miss. It gets underneath Mordaunt. He just has to touch the plate to complete the out, and he does. And that is how the inning ends. Salazar strikes out two, but also walks a couple. Two-run score for Salem on a wild pitch and a bases-loaded walk. Time for us to stretch for the first time at Purdue Stadium in 2024. It's 5-2 Salem now on the Shorebirds Baseball Network, MILB.TV, and Bally Live. Shorebirds find themselves down by three, 5-2. Red Sox played a couple in the last half inning without the benefit of a hit. Five walks helped them score twice. And now Zach Fogle back to the slab. First pitch to Aaron Estrada, who turns around to bat right-handed, is up and out. First at bat for him as a right-hander. First lefty it's pitched against Delmarva this year as the pitch is on the outside corner this time. From Fogle, it's 1-1. Estrada has one of the eight hits for the Shorebirds, but they do not have a hit since this fourth inning. 1-1 pitch, foul back as he sprays it to our right, 1-2. It's been the big innings and a bit of a quiet offense for the Shorebirds in the second half of games that has hurt them here through the first three and a half. And that one's on the outside corner. Estrada goes down looking. Fogle whistles a fastball right by him. It is strikeout number three for him. Second looking. One away from Cole Ehrman. And Delmarva has yet to score a run the seventh inning or later this year. First pitch to Ehrman is a ball just outside, and the count is 1-0 to the Delmarva first baseman. Fogle works quickly the 1-0 pitch. Ehrman takes one upstairs, and it's quickly 2-0. Trying to get somebody aboard here. That's kind of been the key so far for Delmarva as catcher Johan Fring Garcia comes out to talk with his pitcher here. And from the sixth inning and on in games, and you count what has occurred so far tonight, the Shorebirds are being outscored 19-1 in the sixth inning or later. They've had leads in every single game. They just have not been able to finish, and it is a young team that is learning as they go, and never know, some of the games they've been in so far, maybe ones they win in a few weeks, a month, you never know, but the talent is certainly there, just trying to piece it together for full nine-inning games here as we're just getting started. As Ehrman bounces one off the bat, it goes off the glove of the catcher Fogle, or the pitcher rather, and because of that, it's going to turn into a base hit for Ehrman. If Fogle lets that go, it's probably a routine ground ball out, but he redirected it between second, and Lugo had to change direction and couldn't get to it in time. So Cole Ehrman has his first hit of the season. He is aboard, brings the tying run to the on-deck area. And now Leandro Arias to the plate. And Brylan Tavera moving on deck. And out comes the pitching coach for Salem, and Juan Rivera. You take him any way you can get him. As Tavera will give the glue stick to Arias, who gets a better grip on the bat in the meantime. Hits are now even at 9 apiece, but and the walks last inning helping the Red Sox score two more. And a couple tough defensive plays in there as well for the Shorebirds. Only the latter one came back to hurt them on the single by Blaze that turned into a two-base error. And allowed an unearned run to score, and now the Shorebirds into rally mode in a spot they've been a little familiar with here in the early going, trying to find a way to make some noise here in their home opener. Five to Salem, bottom half of the seventh inning. Herman leads off of first. Vogel comes home with it and fires one right down the chute. First pitch fastball to Arias, who is 1-for-3. Scored the first of two runs in the third. Those are the only two runs that Marva has tonight. 0-1. And he's swinging a foul held on to by the catcher, Garcia. Quickly nothing and two, and Arias calls his timeout. Trying to bring Brylan Tavera to the plate as a chance to be the tying run. Arias has to get aboard for him. Oh, 2 pitch. A cue shot off the end of the bat towards first, but foul as he throws the bat head at it and stays alive. Still 0-2 to Arias, batting for the fourth time. Red Sox pitching in this game has a lot better job controlling the zone. They have not walked anyone tonight. 0-2 pitch. It's in the dirt, scooped up by Garcia. 1-2 the count. Jettison to Paez. Paez the starter when 4 innings, struck out 5. No walks allowed. He did give up 8 hits, however. Fogle on the mound just gave up his first hit. It was an infield knock off the bat of Ehrman. He struck out 3. Working ahead here to Arias, 1-2. A pitch coming back. Arias takes it low. Good take by the Delmarva shortstop, who is also batting right-handed for the first time. One of two switch hitters on the roster. Estrada is the other one. Trying to find a way to muscle one to the gap somewhere and bring Brylan Tavera to the plate. 2-2. A swing and a looper to short. Alcantara climbs the ladder and makes the catch as he got to the spot in time. You know, the timeout has jumped perfectly and, more importantly, just got there in time as it hung up long enough for him. But Arias is out. And now 2 gone for Brylan Tavera. That will be it for Fogle, though. Just shy of 30 pitches is manager Liam Carroll. He is out of the dugout. He will make the change as an arm comes in from the bullpen. Tavera will face a new batter, or a new pitcher, rather. With 2 outs here in the bottom of the seventh, Cole Ehrman at first. Tavera set to hit. Red Sox lead it 5-2. Here from Salisbury, we're back in just a moment on the Shorebirds Baseball Network, Valley Live and MILB.TV. Red Sox bring in their third pitcher of the game. Jettison Paez started. Zach Fogle went 2 2/3 out of the bullpen, and now right-hander Isaac Stevens is in. Right-hander from Oklahoma State, 16th round pick By the Red Sox last July. He is making his second career appearance. He pitched for Salem on opening night, did not throw after Salem, or I should say the Red Sox drafted him in last year's draft. His first batter he faces will be Brylan Tavera. He's still looking for that first hit. This would be a good time for it, trying to bring the tying run to the plate. But Stevens is on, facing Tavera, the two batter. First pitch is swung and sent right back up the middle, and right on cue, it's the first single A hit for Brylan Tavera. And that will bring the tying run to the plate here, and Tomas Sosa, a capable home run hitter, trying to see if he can do some big damage here to even this game. He's put together some good at-bats, Tavera. He was due for one of those, so he's at first. Ehrman to second. Both of them getting their first hits of the season, and now it's Sosa. He's going to try and put the Shorebirds back in business here. Down by three. 5-2 Salem lead here in the bottom of the seventh with two outs. Stevens working out of the stretch. First pitch to Sosa. He throws a changeup, and it's a strike. Nothing in one. Stevens on opening night. Two innings. Gave up two hits and two runs. However, they were both unearned. Two walks as well with three strikeouts. Took a blown save in that as well. 0-1 pitch is strike two. Pounds a fastball to the outside corner, and Sosa down 0-2. Sosa is 0-3 today with that last hit. Delmarva is out hitting Salem in this game, 10-9. The walks have added up now a little bit here for the Shorebirds pitching staff. 0-2, a swing and a grounder up the middle. Alcantara moves over to field it, fires over to first, and they'll get the out there. Sosa hit it well, but the Red Sox didn't feel well positioned to play it, and the Shorebirds will strand a couple in the seventh inning. To the eighth we go, Salem 5, Delmarva 2 on the Shorebirds Baseball Network, Valley Live and MLB.TV. Top of the order coming up for Salem. Their lead remains 5-2 as the Shorebirds strand a pair of singles in the bottom of the seventh. Robbie El Salazar has his second inning facing Miguel Blais to start. First pitch, he had a big cut but chased one in the dirt. It's Salazar up early, 0-1. Salazar entered last inning with the bases loaded and one out. He allowed a couple inherited men to score. On bases loaded, walk and a wild pitch. The 0-1, Blais pops one up a mile high near first. Foul territory, Ehrman and Mordan are there. It'll be Mordan with the helmet in his hand. It will drop right in front of him. Probably an easier play for Ehrman, but Mordan made the call on it, and that will be an error on Mordan. You can't have an error on a foul ball play like that. As Mordan just missed it, he was there and was holding that mask in his hand. They typically tell you to just chuck that as far as you can and focus on the baseball. And he ends up missing it, and that'll be the third error of the night on Delmarva. But the count is 0-2. The pitch is slowly tapped in front of home. It'll be played by Mordani. Bare hands from his knees, throws to first, and the ball is picked by Ehrman at first to get the speedy Blais. So Mordan missed the foul ball, but makes the play there as he makes the throw from his knees on a short hop that Ehrman makes the play on. So works past that play there, and now there is one away for Antonio Anderson. 2-3 on that last put out, if you're still keeping track with us. Here's Anderson batting for the fifth time. Salazar's pitch to him is hit sharply on the ground, but right to second where Aaron Estrada is. Easy toss to first, and there are quickly two gone in the Salem eighth. Back-to-back ground balls by Salazar, who does a good job keeping that ball low in the zone. Gets a lot of ground balls when he's right. And now Johan Garcia. And Los Santos, Mordan, and Tejada do up for the Shorebirds in the next half inning. Salazar's first pitch is a mighty hack and a miss by Garcia. I mentioned it last inning, the Shorebirds are out hitting Salem, but the walks are the difference in this one. Six for Delmarva pitching compared to none for Salem, as another swing and a miss at one in the dirt. For Garcia, it's 0-2. It hasn't been that big inning tonight for the Shorebirds against them. A pair of two-run innings and the single tally in the sixth, but it's been a methodical approach, and the pitching for Salem has been very good tonight despite the 10 hits. 0-2 off Arena, swing and a miss, and Salazar on three pitches makes quick work of Garcia. Second time he's punched out tonight. Nice inning of work on the mound for Grabiel Salazar. 7.5 through from Purdue Stadium. It's still 5-2 Salem on the Shorebirds Baseball Network. Anderson De Los Santos starts the home eighth. Shorebirds down three with six outs to work with. And one of their hottest bats to begin 2024. We'll look to get it started here as De Los Santos will bat right-handed against Isaac Stevens out for his first full inning of work. Got the final out for Zach Fogle in the seventh. First pitch to DeLo, misses up and out, and it's 1-0. 2 2/3 for Fogle. He retired the first seven batters he faced. Was unable to get that final out in the seventh, just shy of 30 pitches. 1-0, a swing and a hot shot deep to right. Blaze back at the track. He jumps and makes the catch against the fence. Nice awareness out there by Miguel Blaze, who got turned around but knew exactly where he was. Makes the catch on the track as he softly taps into the wall in right field. Another hard hit ball by De Los Santos, but unfortunately for him, no results on this one. And now here is Anudis Mordan. Shorebirds down by three, need some base runners here. Stevens against the Delmarva catcher. First pitch is down the middle. First pitch fastball from the right-hander. Mordan, two more hits today. He's added an RBI as well. That one to dead center his last time up, but Jostickson Garcia was there to catch it. 0-1 pitch is softly tapped foul. Near the third base coach's box, the count is 0-2. Shorebirds action in the bullpen. Bryner Sanchez is playing catch. Likely slated for the Shorebird top of the ninth inning. Gabriel Salazar, a nice eighth inning for him. Put down the Red Sox in order with a strikeout of Garcia to go along with it. And right through the top of the order, 0-2, a foul as he fights one back off his hands. Both these teams looking for their first wins. Tough series to start off the year. Salem at home against Carolina, lost all three. The opening night one was the hardest for them to swallow. Had a good comeback attempt that fell short on Sunday. 0-2 pitch, a swing and a miss, and Mordaunt strikes out. Slowed him down with a breaker. It's a strikeout for Stevens, his first. And there is one away. Here's Angel Tejada, or two away, rather. Fourth strikeout on the young season for Stevens. And now Tejada, who is 1-for-3 today. Well, bat with the bases empty. Righty on righty matchup. First pitch from Stevens. A slow-moving slider. Comes across for a strike. It's 0-1. And Delmarva's best chance for a big inning themselves was in the second. Remember, they loaded the bases with nobody out, but did not score. At three consecutive singles against the starter, Paez, the 0-1 pitch is just outside. And the count is 1-1. And Delmarva in this game is 2-for-8 with runners in scoring position. They have stranded 7. 1-1 pitch is too low. Another sweeper from Stevens, but this time Tejada lays off. Red Sox in this game have had a lot more opportunities. They are 2-for-12 with runners in scoring position. They've stranded 10. 2-1 pitches outside, 3-1. They've been methodically able to tie this game and now take the lead over the last couple of innings. Salazar's scoreless eighth was the first time the Red Sox were held off the board since the fourth inning. And now working with a 3-run lead. Tejada trying to extend this inning for Steven Acevedo. Full shift on for Salem. 3-1 pitch is fouled away to the right side as he sprays one into the seats. 3-2 now. Sanchez continues to get loose for Delmarva. Bullpen quiet for Salem. This is all Stevens, who has worked with a pretty efficient pitch count so far. 14 total throws, 10 in the zone. 3-2. A swing and a foul. Tejada stays alive. First time this year Tejada has done the DHing. Has a start at second and third base already this year. He did not play on Saturday. And a lot of firsts early in the season last year. Also played a lot of outfield as well. 3-2. A swing and a miss. Stevens strikes him out with the gas. Tejada late to it. He strikes out a pair in the eighth, and the Shorebirds are down in order. Ninth inning coming up. Red Sox trying to hold on and get their first win. They lead the Shorebirds 5-2 on the Delmarva Shorebirds Baseball Network, MILB.TV, and Valley Live.
Who was the first president of the United States who served in U.S. Navy? Was it A, John Kennedy, B, Richard Nixon, C, Ronald Reagan, or D, Harry Truman? And was it Nixon? It's not the giver. John Fitzgerald Kennedy. If you guessed Kennedy, you are correct. Thank you for playing along in the Shorebirds Military Trivia presented by Cohenga of Salisbury. Cohenga, what's your game design?
Blasted into play here in the home opener for the Shorebirds, who currently trail by a score of 5-2. Reiner Sanchez is in for Delmarva, the right-hander making his second appearance of the season. First one was a rough one for him. He gave up 4 runs on 2 hits with 3 walks in his debut on Saturday against Fredericksburg. That was highlighted by a grand slam by A big power hitter for Fredericksburg, Brandon Pimentel, who ended up picking up 8 RBIs in that game for the Nationals. Marvin Alcantara starts it off. First pitch from Sanchez is right down the middle. And if you haven't seen the breaking news yet, big news with the Orioles. Jackson Holliday has just been called up. He will be joining the big league club in Boston tomorrow. 0-1 pitch. There's a strike. It's 0-2. Hard to believe. You look back a year ago, Holliday was playing in this ballpark or the Shorebirds. Now about a calendar year later, he's going to be suiting up for the Orioles. 0-2. He's down and away. 1-2. Holliday, along with a lot of hitters on that Norfolk Tide team, has been off to a scorching hot start. One ball and 2 strikes. Alcantara working behind against Sanchez. The pitch is on the outside corner. Dots the eye and strikes out Alcantara. A nice start to the outing for Sanchez as he gets Alcantara on strikes for the third time.
Now that he goes, center fielder number 28, Justin Garcia.
On the way here, and here's Justin Garcia. Shorebirds down 5-2. They'll have the bottom of their order due up in the ninth inning. First pitch to Garcia. Slider down and away, 1-0. Acevedo, Estrada, and Ehrman, if anyone gets on, and the Shorebirds will need some base runners. Arias on the top of the order would come up. Pitch to Garcia. He had a king's hack, but comes up empty. 1-1. Infield backed up and playing Garcia straight up. Right center is wide open though. 1-1 pitch. Broken bat. Slow roller to third. Played by De Los Santos. Flips it on the run. It is off the mark. And it'll go off the sidewall as Garcia will reach safely. It'll be an error on Anderson De Los Santos, who had some time to set himself. Garcia runs well, but I think if he sets himself and makes a good throw, he gets him easily, but kind of rushed that one and throws it wide of the mark. It stayed in play, so Garcia only stays at first base. It's going to be an E5, and it's the fourth error of the game on Delmarva, a young season high. Had 2 in each of the last 2 games, did not commit an error on opening night. First pitch is a strike on the inside corner. It's 0-1 to Nelly Taylor. Trying to shore up the defense in the early stages. The 0-1 is outside, 1-1.
Come on, Nelly.
De Los Santos has shown to be a very good defender at third base, but that one just a little bit off the mark. He's got a very good throwing arm. There goes Garcia. Pitches low, more down, fires it down on a hop. It's going to be late as it was wide out towards short. Arias played the hop, but Garcia has the steal. It'll be the third stolen base tonight for Salem. Garcia has his first. Red Sox, prior to this game, had 3 steals altogether in the Carolina series. They have matched that total in 1 game tonight. Rodon has thrown one out, though. He threw out Nelly Taylor back in the second inning. And now Garcia in an insurance run in scoring position. 2-1, chopped to second on 2 hops. Estrada gloves it, fires on to first, and gets Taylor. But up to third goes Garcia, so that steal helps Salem stay out of a potential double play ball. But it moves another run 90 feet closer for Stanley Tucker. Tucker 0 for 4 today. He has struck out in 3 of his 4 at-bats. And they're going to make Sanchez get rid of that baseball, very disgruntled. Reiner Sanchez throwing that against the dugout. Tucker bats, Garcia at third, infield backed up. Pitch is a bullseye from Sanchez. Nothing and one the count. Garcia reached on an error. That'd be an unearned run that scores, as would any other subsequent runs that were to come in. But Sanchez trying to get through this inning clean. The pitch is down low and away. Good backhanded stop by Mordon. 1-1 the count. Sanchez proved to be an effective reliever last year for Delmarva, had his 1 save against the Red Sox in Salem in July last year and had some good moments in the middle of the season. 1-1 pitch is inside, 2-2. At start of the year, had extended spring training, then got some work in the Florida Complex League before joining the Shorebirds in June of last year. He had 15 total appearances with Delmarva. 2-1 is a knee-high strike, 2-2. 25 strikeouts and just shy of 20 innings. Converted the 1 save, as mentioned, against Salem. total of 15 hits against him in that span. 2-2 pitch is just a bit down and out. And the count will run full here. First base is open if a walk occurs here for Sanchez, who's trying to avoid the hit from Tucker, who's 0 for 4, looking to go right after him. The 3-2 is up and away. He lost him. A walk to Tucker, and that will put him at the corners with two outs for Albert Feliz. Ardell Marva, their seventh walk of this game, all from the bullpen. And they got another great start in this game as Riley Cooper went three shutout in his professional debut, struck out five. He stranded four runners out there, had four hits against him. None of them came in to score. All the starters for Delmarva on the young season have pitched well. They faced adversity and overcame it as the pitch to Feliz is a strike. It's 0-1. With runners at the corners, you might see Tucker try and take off here. They've all thrown well, but it's been the second half of games that has been their Achilles heel in the young season. Tucker's running, pitches high. Mordaunt pumps the throw. He'll wisely eat it. I think the right decision there to let Tucker take second uncontested. Fourth steal today for the Red Sox. They're at second and third now with the count 1-1. It's one of those things. Sanchez is throwing the baseball well with two outs. I think you're better off just going after the hitter here rather than messing around. 1-1 pitch. There's a strike. Pounds one to the outside corner. 1-2. You know, Jostickson Garcia at third is an aggressive base runner. He certainly would be looking to come home if the throw did go to second. It's a 1-2 count, though, to Feliz. Here's the pitch from Sanchez. It is a called strike three. Pins one right on the outside corner, and Sanchez strikes out a pair in the top of the ninth. But Delmarva needs to get the bats going, and right now, three outs to work with. They're down by three. 5-2 Salem. Bottom of the ninth is next on the Shorebirds Baseball Network. Last call for the Shorebirds. They trail 5-2 here on opening night at Purdue Stadium, a game they led 2-0. With five unanswered runs by the Red Sox has them up a field goal with three outs to get. Acevedo, Estrada, and Ehrman do up. If anyone gets out on the top of the order and make its way to the plate for the Shorebirds. And Isaac Stevens trying to earn the save in relief. For the Red Sox, get the final seven outs of this game. First pitch to Acevedo is fouled back. It's 0-1. Trying to make a winner out of Zach Fogle in relief. He was excellent in his 2 2/3 innings. Jedickson Paez went four as the Salem starter, gave up two runs. Only one of them was earned. Nothing in one. Stevens pitches and he misses just a bit wide, says Gustavo Garza. 1-1 to Acevedo, who's 1-for-3. He's also stolen a base today. Ready on ready matchup, the break-even pitch. A half swing, they ask, and he went, says Derek Pacheco at first. And the count is now 1-2. No argument from Acevedo. That bat head just got a little too far out in front. And Stevens has Acevedo down 1-2. The key to one of these ninth inning rallies like Delmarva needs is always getting that leadoff hitter aboard. Acevedo trying to deliver. 1-2. And he's swinging a miss. Fastball, letter high. He couldn't catch it. And Stevens strikes out Acevedo to start the ninth. He has punched out the last three Delmarva hitters. One away for Aaron Estrada. Estrada hit himself tonight, trying to put himself on for the second time. Looking for his first multi-hit game of the season. Stevens deals to him, and he hits the outside corner. A slow-moving breaker gets him ahead. Estrada a single with a strikeout and a pop-out to third. Infield backed up a step for Salem. 0-1 pitch is outside. Called the ball, 1-1. Back at it tomorrow. Same start time, 7:05. We'll hit the air around 6:50 for the on-deck show. Nestor Herman makes his professional debut for the Shorebirds. Noah Dean, left-hander, gets the start for the Red Sox. 1-1. Is a strike knee high on the inside part, and Estrada's down 1-2. Trey Gibson makes his first start for Delmarva on Thursday. Blake Money was excellent on Saturday for the Shorebirds. He'll get the Friday start. Luis De Leon Saturday. Michael Ferret on Sunday for the finale. 1-2 is outside a ball, 2-2. Nestor Herman, like the starter today, Riley Cooper, going to make his long-awaited professional debut tomorrow. Ball two, strike two to Estrada. The pitch from Stevens, a swing and a foul held on to by the catcher Garcia, and Delmarva is down to their final out. Four consecutive strikeouts for Isaac Stevens, and it will be up to Cole Ehrman to extend this game. 12 strikeouts now for the Delmarva offense, with most of that coming against the bullpen. Ogle and Stevens have combined for 7. First pitch to Ehrman is right down the middle. Nothing won the count. Post game coverage follows our broadcast here tonight. Get you the foul totals and summaries. Scores from around Birdland as well as the Carolina League. Get you more on the Jackson Holiday News as Ehrman flies a soft one into center. Garcia coming on. He will get there, and the Red Sox have their first win of the season. Shorebirds stay winless as they fall in the home opener 5-2. Five unanswered runs by Salem gets them the come-from-behind win. We'll step aside, come back with the postgame totals and summaries in just a few moments on the Shorebirds Baseball Network, MILB.TV, and Valley Live.
And the Shorebirds will next be home tomorrow as it's the first Silver Sliders Wednesday of the season, presented by Peninsula Home Care. And on Friday, Tyler's amazing balancing act makes its return. And Saturday, it's the best fireworks show on Delmarva with SWBOC Fireworks. Save time. Buy your tickets online at theshorebirds.com/ticket. Once again, the final score of tonight's game, Red Sox 5, the Shorebirds 2. Shorebirds, thank you for attending tonight's game, and please travel home safely. We appreciate your continued support. Thank you.
Welcome to the postgame show here from Purdue Stadium on opening night here in Salisbury. The Shorebirds fall short 5-2 Kind of the same script that we've seen through the first three games. Delmarva jumped out to an early lead, got great starting pitching, but unfortunately not able to get any offense late in the game as the Red Sox come back to win this one 5-2. Haven't seen that big inning that the Shorebirds have been hindered by the first three games, but the Red Sox methodically able to make it happen as they win it by three, picking up their first win of the season, while Delmarva falls to 0-4. Mitchell Speltz with you to wrap things up here on the postgame as we go through the final totals and summaries of this one. First for the Salem Red Sox, 5 runs on 9 hits, 1 error, 12 runners on the base. Shorebirds, 2. Runs, 10 hits. They out-hit the Red Sox in this one, but committed 4 errors. Stranded 7 on base and also walked 7 batters in this game pitching-wise, all of them from the bullpen as the Red Sox took advantage of a handful of those, one in the 7th, and they walked 5 times to help them score twice. Winning pitcher is Zach Fogle. He picks up his first win of the season. The loss goes to Jure Frias. He's 0-1. Isaac Stevens collects his first professional save by recording the final 7 outs for Salem. Time of the ballgame, 2 hours and 30 minutes. Still do not have an official attendance for you. We'll pass that along for you if we get it before we sign off today. Final look around the Carolina League. Most games have gone final. One is still going. Myrtle Beach at Columbia. Pelicans lead the Fireflies by 1 on the road in the bottom of the 8th inning. Otherwise, everything else is a final. Kannapolis beats Augusta 3-1. Fayetteville over